In this lecture class, I will discuss triggering circuit based on UJT oscillator. Last class, we have discussed about working principle of UJT circuit. There we have seen that if the input voltage is increased more than the peak voltage, then the UJT will be on. In that case, emitter current will increase and voltage will decrease. The point at which UJT turns on is peak voltage, and the current is increased up to valley current. And if the emitter voltage is less than the valley voltage, then UJT will be off. Based on that, a oscillator circuit is developed which can trigger a SCR. SCR will be on in the negative resistance region. So UJT oscillator triggering circuit. In this circuit, you can see there are resistances R1, R2, R, UJT having three terminals E, V1, V2. A DC voltage VVV is applied. Here, the capacitor voltage will work like a emitter voltage. In this circuit, suppose initially UJT is off, then capacitor will charge through resistance R exponentially, and maximum voltage developed across the capacitor C1 will be VVV. But if the voltage across the capacitor is equal to the peak point voltage of the UJT, then the UJT will be on. R1, R2 are very small resistances, comparatively lesser than RB1 and RB2. So when the capacitor voltage reaches peak point voltage, then the UJT will be on and current will flow through VVV, R2, B2, B1, R1. So there will be a voltage developed across the resistance R1, and this voltage, here it is marked as V0, output voltage, and this voltage will be applied across the thyristor gate to cathode junction. So if this voltage is equal to the minimum gate to cathode voltage required to turn on the SCR, then the thyristor will be on. So very simple circuit is there. Again, I am repeating this one. When the UJT is off, capacitor will charge, capacitor voltage equal to the peak voltage, then UJT will be on and capacitor will discharge through C1, E, B1, R1 and back to C1. And it is to be noted here that if the capacitor voltage is less than the valley voltage after discharging, then the UJT will be off and the output voltage will be 0. Again, the capacitor will charge and it will discharge at peak voltage. So this cycle will repeat. So let's discuss some basic points about UJT. So UJT is a highly efficient switch. Its switching time is in the range of nanoseconds. Generally, in case of SCR, we know that once the SCR is on, it will remain on. So anyhow, we have to break the junction to turn on the SCR, and for that a pulse is required. Here, the voltage developed across the resistance R1 will serve as the triggering pulse of the SCR. The external resistances R1 and R2 are very low in comparison to RB1 and R. Capacitor C1 charges through R exponentially till VVV, towards VVV. Because before VVV, a peak point will be there, and at that point, capacitor will discharge through R1. During this process, VC1 is equal to VE is equal to VVB into 1 minus e to the power minus t by R1. You can get this expression by applying a DC excitation across simple RC series circuit. In this case, it is assumed that initial capacitor voltage is 0. So equation number 3 will give the capacitor voltage. Last class also we have discussed that VP is equal to eta VVB plus VD. The junction EB1 breakdown and the UJT will be turned off. Capacitor discharges through R1. The voltage V0 is applied across SCR. And one point to be noted here that after discharging, if the capacitor voltage is less than valley voltage VV, then the UJT will be turned off and again the capacitor will charge through R. So let's discuss these things in detail. Here in this graph, you can see that capacitor voltage, where it is emitter voltage, initially it increases up to peak point, then after peak point it discharges. Capacitor C1 charges through R exponentially towards VBV. Now, if initial capacitor voltage is VV, at t equal to 0 capacitor voltage is VV, valley point voltage. Then the expression of peak point voltage VP is equal to eta VVV plus VD is equal to VV into e to the power minus t by RC1 plus VVV into 1 minus e to the power minus t by RC1. So at t equal to 0, capacitor voltage is VV. So here in the equation number 4, initial capacitor voltage is considered. But in equation number 3, it is not shown. Now from equation number 4, as VB is very low and voltage drop across diode, VD we are considering 0.3 to 0.7 volt. So these two voltages VB and VD can be ignored, and finally we will get eta is equal to 1 minus e to the power minus t by RC1. Taking log on both sides and solving this equation number 5, we can write t is equal to RC1 log of 1 by 1 minus eta. Here t is nothing but time period, and it is equal to 1 by frequency, and the time period is equal to charging time plus discharging time. Generally discharging time is very low, so that can be ignored. So t is equal to 1 by RC1 log of 1 by 1 minus eta. Now from this graph you can see at the time of discharging, the output voltage across resistance R1 is developed. This output voltage is fed across gate to cathode junction of thyristor. So only during the discharging period our thyristor can be on. So for a very small time duration, this pulse will appear across the SCR and the SCR will be on. Because this is the general condition that a peaky gate pulse is sufficient to turn on the SCR. It is too much faster than resistance and RC firing circuit, and the power loss across the circuit is also very low. So today we have discussed about thyristor triggering based on UJT. Here UJT is used as a switch. When the UJT is on, then voltage will develop across resistance and that voltage will trigger the SCR, and when the UJT is off, gate pulse will not appear across SCR and thyristor will continue to conduct because of its basic property. So a small amount of gate pulse is given just to trigger the SCR. So this circuit saves lots of power compared to resistance and RC firing circuit. So it is highly efficient circuit and is preferred over R and RC for triggering a SCR. Thank you.